This is Chilin from MAQ. Starting from this year, we started to deliver the fine boring product series. And in today's video, we're gonna show you how to settle the tool, how to fine adjust the tool, so that you can create fine tolerance holes in your machine. In this case, what I'm holding in my hand is a CKB2 type. And the diameter of the body is roughly 24 millimeter. The total length is about 100 millimeter, and it has a ENH2 type connection to the insert holder here. And with this body, you can make holes with diameter range between 25 up to 47 millimeter. And of course, it has the coolant through. So when you get such a tool, and the first step, of course, is to check which type of insert holder you have. So in this case, it's a little bit difficult to see, but I'm gonna put a bigger picture later on so you can see it clearly. And it's ENH2/1, so it's the first type. And pay a little bit of attention to our catalog. There you can find with this insert holder, which is the size of the hole that it can create when you put it on the body of the CKB2 product. And this product, the first series we have, you can also check on our website. First series we have actually covers up to 7 times the diameter in fine bore applications. And of course, we are going to enlarge the assortment to come up with more longer tools and so on. And after you have received the tool, and sometimes you have to exchange the insert holder. And in that case, you want to make sure that the locking screw, which has a lock symbol here engraved, that you lock it first, and then you can untie the screw here to exchange the insert holder. But of course, here today, we're not going to do anything. So make sure to find out where is the locking screw position, because on the upside of the locking screw position, there's also a hole, and it's usually filled up with some type of plastic. And this hole you should not touch, because here you have a alignment mechanism inside. And if you remove it, you can actually damage the mechanism for the fine adjustment. So here comes the fine adjustment fine adjustment scale. And before you do any kind of adjustment, it's very important to notice that you should actually unscrew or unlock the locking screw here, so that the mechanism inside has the capacity to move in and out. And each division on the scale is roughly 10 micrometer in a diameter. So in this case, if I unlock the screw here, and I adjust myself by about, say, 1 division. I actually have changed the diameter that is going to machine by 10 micrometer. And after that is done, you can just lock the screw here. And on the bottom of the tool, there is a oil nipple. And this is used when the lubricants inside the tool holder is not sufficient. Then you can use the oil nipple, which has a plungeable in the front, you can use it to inject some of the fat to lubricate the mechanism, so that it's less of a backlash when you use the product in the machine. On the back of the body, then you have this connection mechanism, which you are using to couple to the master shanks. And in this case, it's a CKB interface. And normally you have this different type of master shanks, and you just want to make sure that when you use it, the total, so to say, the airbed ratio from the flange surface up to the insert doesn't exceed the working length that is defined in the catalog. In this case, it's 7 times the diameter. And in this case, in a screw position, there are 2 set of holes. The first one is the crossing holes here. The second set is here. And this set of holes is used for the stiffening pins. In our case, since it's doing the fine bone applications, we don't need it. We actually only use the cross holes here. And you see it has actually had a taper shape. So what it does is that when you put it in the master shank, what has happened is that when you tighten the screw, when you tighten the screw, the further this screw gets into the position, it starts to use a wedge phenomenon to lock the boring tool towards the master shank. So now it's set it up. Now the tool is assembled into the master shank, and we're gonna put it into the spindle. So when you have this master shank already installed in the machine, and for example, in this case, it's an ISO 40 or it's a SK40, where you have the slots for the drive keys, and you also have a feature here, which is used for alignment. Be very careful when you set up the tool. So that in this case, when I use this cross holes here, I'm gonna make sure that the insert holder somehow is aligned with the drive key and to the surface where you have the feature here as an indication, and then you can lock it, of course. And then it's set up, and be careful in case you have installed the tool in the other way around, because then what can happen is that when you retract the tool after the hole is done, you want the tool first to go to the center and then up, right? And if you are on the wrong side of the tool holder, what happens is that then the insert can actually stay here and move to the left first and then go up. Then it will scratch the surface of the workpiece to make a dent, which is actually not good. So remember to make sure that double check your NC program regarding the tool retraction for the boring tools, and make sure they align properly. Normally you have a hole that you have made, and you can use the hole diameter to calibrate the position of the cutting edge on the fine boring product. When you have made a hole already with this tool, and you measure the size of the hole, and then you can use the diameter of the hole as a calibration to find the sear point of the insert. And after that, you can adjust the position of the insert so that you can go to the point where you want to create your hole size, let's say. And as normally, the first step is that you unscrew the locking screw here. So make it loose. And then you come to here and try to be very careful here, because it's 1, 2, and you see it's between 2 and 3. So I'm now
changing the diameter of the insert holder by 100 microns, 100 micrometer. And after that, I can lock the insert holder